Hello and welcome to this third organ recital in the series that we've had in CQ 2020, which was the lockdown term for us all. We've had two recitals already, one by the school organist Jamal Sutton, who gave a recital on the Harrison and Harrison organ in the main chapel, and by Owen Chan, our star organ pupil who's about to leave us and go on to be organ scholar at Merton College, Oxford, who played at home on his electronic organ using the Hauptvecht software. So do go and visit those two recitals if you haven't already heard them. This third concert is has evolved into a tour of the four different pipe organs in Charterhouse. And I start off with the Harrison and Harrison in chapel, but then I move around to play all four. We're delighted that the technology that we've explored, because we've had to this term, has enabled us to accelerate that programme from now on, and that all of our concerts, all our pupil performances, will be recorded and made available for the whole community to hear from now on. It's been great for me too personally. It's great that even old dogs can learn new tricks, and you will hear at least and see one piece in this recital which is abysmally put together, one of my earlier attempts, and then some of the latter ones are a little bit better, and I must thank Mr. Sutton for his incredible patience and goodwill in nurturing me and leading me through that whole process. So I start in chapel on the main organ, which is in a pretty sorry state at the moment. There's a lot of wind leakage noise, and there's a note that keeps sticking at no extra charge, and there are stops that create problems. They don't quite go off when you want them to go off, so they start sort of bleating in the background. Anyway, bear with that. The first piece is the Fantasy by Saint-Saens. The opening piece is pure ballet music, lots of humour in it, a very light and deft touch, it's beautiful, followed by a snappy fugue. It's sort of erudite fairground music, if that's not too paradoxical. Beautifully put together and hopefully puts a smile on your face as well. Oh, and by the way, I'm afraid that this is the smartest I look at any time in this recital, because I put it together over a period of weeks, often when the weather was rather hot. So please make allowances. Thank you. Here's Saint-Saens Fantasy in E-flat.
Thank you.
The second piece I'm going to play is a delightful little prelude by Bach in A major, and I've chosen it just to show off the little two-manual organ in Founders Chapel. It's not a particularly beautiful organ, but it does have the edge on the Memorial Chapel, Harrison, because it's clear and you can hear every note. So here's Bach's A major prelude. The next piece I'm going to play is back in the Memorial Chapel on the Harrison. It's called Tuba Tune by Norman Cocker, and it is a dialogue between the one loudest stopper in the organ, the tuba, and the main chorus of the organ. And then latterly they combine to give us a real sort of Edwardian romp. I hope you enjoy it. Thank you. fugue by Handel. A fugue is a piece where an individual voice is heard at the outset and then it's imitated by other voices. It's a very clever construct and Handel was very good at it. The organ I'm going to play on is in the Hen Roost, which is part of the old chapel, now converted into a music school. And it's a fantastic practice organ. Fantastic because you cannot hide anywhere. It's very precise and easy to make mistakes, but it rewards you if you get things absolutely right. It's got lots of character, and I think it's a much prettier organ than the instrument you've just heard in the Founders Chapel. So it's a worthy asset that we very, very rarely hear. Now we come to the most beautiful and the smallest and newest pipe organ that the school possesses. It's also housed in the Memorial Chapel and it's portable and it's a three-stop, very small chamber organ. And it was commissioned about 5 years ago and donated by one of our OCs, Bill Shipton, in memory of his father. And it is easily the most musical and beautiful instrument that we possess, despite the fact it's very small. And I'm playing a really delightful piece on this called Christ unser Herr zum Jordan kam. Christ went to the Jordan for his baptism. And you can hear this long, continuous flow of semi-quavers in the left hand, which depicts, I assume, depicts the movement of water. And it's based on a hymn tune. Bach wrote many of these chorale preludes using Lutheran melodies. And this uses the hymn tune in the pedal, played by the feet in the bass, as it were. But actually what I've done with this performance, because the chamber organ does not have a pedal board, I have played the manual parts on the chamber organ, and then using the Hen Roost organ, with this sort of rather nasally sounding reed. I've played that on the Henrist organ and dubbed it into the sound mix. The final piece in this concert takes us back to the Memorial Chapel in the Harrison and Harrison, and it is Joseph Schongen's Sonata Eroica, which is a colossal symphonic work for organ written in about 1930, and it shows off and demands all the colours that you can produce from a large symphonic organ, and it, as the title suggests, full of energy and emotion, some beautifully reflective passages as well. Thank you for listening.